السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Inshallah, today we will start our new series about rules of tajweed. Rules of tajweed and أحكام التجويد. أحكام means rules. التجويد, this is to beautify. And we mean here to read Quran in a proper way as the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, peace be with him, and his companions did. So here we are here to read Quran as the Prophet Muhammad did in a proper way. So when I read Quran, when I say بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, this is now you are reading Arabic. Where is Quran? Where is the rules? You should apply where? Okay, you are not reading from a normal book. This is Allah's book, holy book, right? And we have rules for that. And the rules is not difficult. Just you should know when you should stretch your voice, when you should make nasal sound, when you must make this letter say it clearly, or you hide it, or merge it, or convert it, you know, into another letter. This is tajweed rules. So when I say Al-Fatiha, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. No, this is not Quran. What is the rules? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم. And you can feel each letter, you know, الرحمن الرحيم. So inshallah we'll start this series now. أحكام النون الساكنة, أحكام النون الساكنة والتنوين. أحكام النون الساكنة والتنوين. The first main rule in Quran or in Tajweed is related to نون ساكنة and تنوين. So before we start, I want to understand what does نون ساكنة mean. What does نون ساكنة mean? نون ساكنة is the letter نون with سكون. The letter نون that carries سكون. This small round circle above the letter نون called سكون. Called سكون. So when I say نون ساكنة, I mean نون with سكون. I mean the letter نون with سكون. نون ساكنة is the letter نون free from any vowel. No فتحة, no كسرة, and no ضمة. So this is نون ساكنة. Okay, what about تنوين? What does تنوين mean? تنوين is a single vowel. تنوين is a single vowel with a hidden نون ساكنة. And instead of writing a vowel and a نون ساكنة separately, the vowel sign is double. So the letter نون ساكنة is sounded but not written. So here when you see the letter ba with كسرتان, the letter ba with كسرتان means with two كسرات. So the letter ba with كسرتان, كسرتان means two كسرة. The first كسرة is كسرة here, B. The second كسرة is not a vowel. This second كسرة is a hidden نون ساكنة. So I say bin. The same, the letter ba with ضمتان. One ضمّة is U sound, بو. And the second ضمّة here is نون ساكنة, بن. با with فتحتان, با فتحة با. The other فتحة is hidden نون ساكنة, بن. And with تنوين فتحتان, we should have extra ألف after تنوين فتحتان. Whenever there is a نون ساكنة or تنوين, we need to look at the next letter depending on which. There are five possible rules on how the نون is pronounced. And here we have نون ساكنة and تنوين. We understand what is نون ساكنة and we know of course what is تنوين. We said نون ساكنة, the letter نون with سكون. تنوين is a single vowel, the letter with a single vowel with a hidden نون ساكنة. We have five rules. Rule number one, إظهار. Number two, إضغام مع الغنة. Number three, إضغام بلا غنة, without غنة. Number four, إقلاب. Number five, إخفاء. And each rule has its letters. So if I see نون ساكنة or تنوين followed by همزة هاء عين حاء غين خاء, you must do إظهار. If you see نون ساكنة or تنوين followed by ياء نون ميم واو, you should do إضغام merging with غنة, إضغام مع الغنة. If you see نون ساكنة or تنوين followed by لام or را, you should do إضغام بلا غنة, without غنة. If you see نون ساكنة or تنوين followed by the letter ب, you should do إقلاب, change, convert the letter نون ساكنة into a small tiny meme, and we will talk about that inshallah. إخفاء, here we have 6 letters, 4, this is 10, 12, 13 letters from our Arabic letters, 28, so the rest of our Arabic letters are 15. If one of those letters comes after نون ساكنة or تنوين, we should do إخفاء. إخفاء means hiding, and we will know how inshallah. So in this video we'll talk about إظهار. If نون ساكنة or تنوين followed by همزة ها عين حاء غين خاء, we will do إظهار. So we have إظهار, إضغام with غنة, merging with غنة, إضغام without غنة, إقلاب and إخفاء. Rule number one, as we said, الإظهار. الإظهار. So if you see after نون ساكنة or تنوين any of these 6 letters, همزة ها عين حاء غين خاء, what should you do? If you see after نون ساكنة همزة ها عين حاء غين خاء, one of those letters. If you see after تنوين همزة ها عين حاء غين خاء, one of them after تنوين, what should you do? You should do إظهار. إظهار means saying clearly. It means saying the letter نون ساكنة or the نون comes from تنوين clearly without any hiding or merging. Again, the إظهار or the letters of إظهار are حروف الإظهار, همزة ها عين حاء غين خاء. We call them throatal letters. Letters come out from your throat. همزة ها عين حاء غين خاء. If you see نون ساكنة or تنوين followed by one of these 6 letters, همزة ها عين حاء غين خاء, you should do إظهار. Say the letter نون clearly without hiding or merging. If نون ساكنة or تنوين is followed by any of these 6 letters, we should do إظهار. إظهار. همزة ها عين حاء غين خاء. So here, before we start to look at the Quran, at the ayat, how does نون ساكنة look like in Quranic script? If it is followed by إظهار letter, همزة ها عين حاء غين خاء. You will see if you look in the Quran, in the Mus'haf, you will see نون ساكنة like this. نون has something above it, looks like the head of the letter حاء. The head of the letter ha. So this is noon sakina. When you see this sukoon very obvious above the letter noon, it means you should make izhar. You should read this noon clearly. Okay. And after that, I need to know how does tanween look like in Quranic script if it is followed by izhar letter. Hamza ha ayn ha ghayn kha. Tanween in the Quran, in the Mus'haf, if it is followed by one of these letters, همزة ها عين حاء غين خاء, you will see فتحتان like this, above each other exactly. The same كسرتان also above each other, not as Q as we will see later إن شاء الله. ضمتان you will see one ضمة and the other ضمة like this. So this is ضمتان. When I see ضمتان like this, it means you should make إظهار. The noon that comes from تنوين, I mean the second ضمة, we should read it clearly, pronounce it clearly. So this is أن, إن, أن. فتحتان, كسرتان, ضمتان. And now here is examples on نون ساكنة. يوم يفر المرء من أخيه. Do we have نون ساكنة here? Yes, I have نون ساكنة. Followed by what? By همزة or by ألف. And as we said before, if نون ساكنة is followed by any of these six letters, همزة ها عين ها غين خا, we should do إظهار. Here نون ساكنة followed by همزة. So I should do إظهار. What do you mean by إظهار? Say this نون clearly. How? يوم يفر المرء من أخيه. من أخيه. I read it without any, you know, hiding or merging or any nasal sound. You know, if someone say it like this, if someone says it like this, يوم يفر المرء من أخيه. I say, oh, this tone is very good. Look here. يوم يفر المرء من أخيه. But this is wrong. Why? Because I don't do nasal sound. I don't do غنّة when I read the letter نون. I say it without غنّة, without nasal sound. يوم يفر المرء من أخيه. أرأيت الذي ينهى. نون ساكنة. Yes, here. Followed by ها. نون ساكنة. Followed by ها. So I should read this noon clearly. I should do إظهار. How? أرأيت الذي ينهى. 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 أرأيت الذي ينهى. خلق الإنسان من علق. من علق. نون ساكنة. Followed by عين. I should do إظهار. Say this noon clearly. How? من علق. خلق الإنسان من علق. Wrong. Don't make غنة. Don't make nasal sound. Don't wait on this noon. Don't say من علق. No. من علق. خلق الإنسان من علق. And here do we have نون ساكنة? Yes, this is نون ساكنة followed by ح. Before that, this ألف has something above it, looks like the head of the letter صاد. This ألف we call it ألف وصل, and this ألف we don't read it. You don't read it under any circumstances unless you have it at the beginning, or you start your reading from it. Imagine that we don't have this well, and I want to start from this alif. I will say inhar, inhar. I will read it, but you know, between letters like this, no, this alif we don't read it. So I say waw fatha and then nun sukun. This nun sakina followed by ha. So I must say it clearly. How? فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. وَانْحَرْ. وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلْ. مِنْ غِلْ. نون ساكنة followed by غين. نون ساكنة followed by غين. I should do إظهار. Say this noon clearly. نون ساكنة, yes, followed by خا. So I should read this نون clearly without hiding or merging. And of course, no غنة. غنة is a nasal sound. We don't make nasal sound. So I don't say ذلك لمن خشي ربه. Maybe someone will say, oh, this is like nice voice, good tone. When I say لمن خشي ربه, but this is wrong. You break the rules. Here, نون ساكنة followed by خاء I should do إظهار. Read this نون without any hiding, any merging, without any غنة. How? ذلك لمن خشي ربه. And now let's go to تنوين. ومن شر حاسد. حاسد إذا حسد. The letter دال has كسرتان. And as we said before, تنوين is a single vowel with a hidden نون ساكنة. The letter دال here has كسرتان. So دال has one كسرة and the other كسرة here is a hidden نون ساكنة. This نون ساكنة followed by ألف or by همزة. So you should read it clearly. How? ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. نون ساكنة and this is همزة. سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. We have meme with ضمتان. So the first ضمة, okay, we have it here. The second ضمة is a hidden نون ساكنة. This نون ساكنة comes from تنوين, is followed by ها. What should I do? You should read this نون clearly. How? سلام هي. I can't say. سلام هي. This is wrong. Just read without wait on this نون, without غنة, without nasal sound. سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. والفجر وليال عشر. والفجر وليال عشر. Look here. لام. The letter لام has كسرتان. So as we said, it's just one كسرة. The other كسرة is a hidden نون ساكنة followed by عين. So you must say this نون clearly without any hiding or merging. How? وليال عشر. وليال عشر. I can say وليال عشر. Wrong. Don't wait here. Don't make nasal sound. Say it without any nasal sound. Say it without غنة, without hiding, without merging. Make it clear. How? وليال عشر. تصلى. تصلى. Oh, before we start here, the letter T is light, empty mouth letter, and the letter Sad heavy. Some readers said Tasla, Tas, Ta, 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 wrong. This is light and this is heavy. Tasla, Tasla, Naran, Naran, Hamia. The letter Ra has Fathatan. So this ra is ra with fatha, and the other fatha is a hidden noon sakina. We pronounce it, but we don't write it. This noon sakina is followed by ha. So you should read this noon clearly. If tanween followed by any of these six letters, we should do izhar. Say this noon clearly. How? Tasla naran hamia. Naran hamia. قولا غير الذي قيل لهم. The letter lam has فتحتان. So lam with fatha and the other fatha is a hidden noon ساكنة followed by غين. If you see tanween is followed by any of these six letters, همزة ها عين ح غين خاء. What should you do? إظهار. How? قولا غير. قولا غير الذي قيل لهم. وجوه يومئذ خاشعة. تنوين. The letter دال has كسرتان. So the letter ذال. The letter ذال has كسرتان. So the letter ذال has one كسرة. The other كسرة is a hidden نون ساكنة followed by خاء. So I should do إظهار. Say this نون clearly. How? يومئذ خاشعة. وجوه يومئذ خاشعة. As you see here. And this was the first rule, izhar. If you have any question or you know, just email me and inshallah I will try to answer you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.